being a coward in this.
What did you do it?
No, guys. Truthfully speaking, it's a lot harder. And it's not hard because I want a pity party. I threw that away long ago because sometimes what I find we do as a people is we make excuses. Yeah, I was never good enough, I was never black enough, I was never white enough. And we make excuses as to why we're not succeeding. I made sure that I said that there is absolutely nothing you can tell me about myself that will make me not be successful, regardless. It doesn't matter where I'm from, doesn't matter what my limitations are. I will, and for me, it's higher than my ability because it's more my faith. That's the only thing that allows me to believe that I'm able to do way more than what the world thinks I'm, or even qualifies me to do. So I always say, it's fine, guys, I'm called and qualified by God, so I don't actually need the approval. Because what happens in this industry is, speaking about it, people break you down so much. The industry itself breaks you down. And as a colored woman, it's even harder because you don't know where to go. You either have to go, there aren't that many shows. And as a LSM, so an LSM is the ratings that they look at. So they create shows based on ratings. And the ratings are based on the different areas. So that's the viewership, okay? The viewership determines the storyline. The storyline determines the type of audience that I'm gonna watch. And the amount of viewers that you have will determine the sponsorships. So ads, advertisers, pumping money into the show. Scandal, for example, has over 4 million viewers. So obviously the adverts that you see playing in those times are paid for in hundreds of thousands of rand, and that's how it sort of works. But the storylines, because Scandal's LSM is predominantly lower class, somewhat middle class, black viewerships. So their storylines are for that. But then they try to bring, for instance, a colored family in or a colored storyline in. And it doesn't always work because colored people don't really watch it as much as they should be watching it. So then they cut the storyline. I don't want to say we don't support, but black viewerships, for example, black viewers will watch Generations even if the storyline is terrible, because why? They have a part of them that's like, it's my people, I'm going to carry on watching and I'm going to follow it. That's just how it works. Whereas we're not like that. We won't just watch someone because we're like, yes, that girl's from Elders and I'm going to watch it just so that I can watch it because I'm supporting, and yeah, here we go. So they don't want to invest in colored storylines. That is why, if you watch TV across the world, colored storylines are always B storylines or supporting storylines. Very little colored storyline is the storyline of the show.
Yeah.
We come in as supporting actors, one here, one there. Whether you go to Cape Nation, an Afrikaans show, it will be a predominantly white show, and you have a supporting colored character. If you go to Mzansi, you have a predominantly black show and a supporting character. If you go to ETV, you have a predominantly black show and a supporting character. So it's a very difficult industry to break into, because for example, for me, my biggest challenge is that I translate sometimes with fair skin black because of my hair. So I'll go to an audition and I don't have a problem with that. That's the other thing, that you have to be versatile. And it's okay, guys. Listen, it's okay if you read black and you are not black. It's fine. A lot of people have problems with that. It's okay if you're not Indian but you read Indian. Then go for an Indian role. What's the big deal? It's not, you shouldn't be so set in, I'm colored and I'm only going for colored things. If I put a straight wig on now, it changes my look. So I'll tell my agency, if that role is for this, it's fine, I'll put a wig on and I'll be able to change. If the role is for this, my accent can change quickly. I'll be colored now, the way they see colored. Because you have to be like a chameleon, right? But, so I go for these roles. Great, but I can't speak a black language. So they're like, yeah, sorry. Doesn't work, okay? Just lastly to add on to that, so I got a lead role on a show called MTV Sugar, if anyone has seen it. And I played the role of a 16-year-old black girl called Tufelo. So she was this abused black girl, whatever. And initially, when I went for the audition, they were like, can you just put Tswana sentences together because you're playing the role of Tufelo? And I went to Tswana people and I was like, how do you say this? How would I say this? Help me with my pronunciation just so that I can go to the audition.
Sure.
So I prepared like for weeks. I went to the audition and I just put Botswana's love year thing, and I saw the door, and I got the wrong. Problem is, I got and said, I can't speak Tswana.
Really?
I don't know how to speak Tswana. That took forever for me just to get those three sentences. But that's why I'm saying my faith is much higher than what this world has to offer me. Because they changed the whole concept of the role to suit me. I told them, I was like, I can't play this role as a Tswana person. What I gave you in the audition was what I prepared. I don't have time to prepare this. I'm being abused and raped character-wise. I don't have time to think about the thing. And they were like, fine. And then they said, fine, we have to recast. And I said, okay, that's fine. And it's an international show, so I didn't want to lose the job. And then a week later, they came back to me and they said, listen, we have loved your performance and what you've done so far, that we're going to make the colored mother, the character's mother colored, and you were living with her somewhere, you won't see her, and that's why you don't speak Tswana. They changed a story that they brainstormed a year ago to suit me. Hence why I'm saying, yes, there are challenges as a colored person and a colored female, you're going to run into them, trust me. You are so going to run into them, but your faith has to be much higher. And you have to understand, if God purposed me to be here, then he's going to open the doors that need to be opened. I'm on a show that I shouldn't be on. I keep playing these roles that, according to the world, I shouldn't play. But that's because I know who the person is who opens the doors for me. So your faith needs to be so strong, but it is tough. I won't lie to you. It's harder than all the other races. We don't have a support structure in our communities. We don't have shows that cater to tell our stories. Truthfully, people see colored people mostly as one group, which is Cape Town. So if I don't have a Cape Town accent, then I'm apparently not actually colored. But people forget that there are other types of colors from different areas. There's many things, you know, that people, that you struggle. But if this is where you're supposed to be, trust me, he's gonna open the door. Look at, I don't know, I use my life as a testimony.